In this lecture, we will see some properties of p-type semiconductor. So here I am using an example of silicon. So let me write some points about p-type semiconductor. So when a trivalent impurity atoms of group 3 such as boron, aluminium, gallium or indium are introduced into silicon that belongs to group 4 of periodic table, it forms p-type semiconductor. Because here the majority carriers are holes. Second point is a trivalent atom forms 3 covalent bonds to the silicon, while fourth valence electron of silicon remains unbounded due to deficiency of one electron. So here in this image we can see that when we introduce impurity atoms that belong to group 3 of periodic table, in this way, since this atom has valency 3, so this silicon atom can make 3 bond with this boron atom, but the fourth electron of silicon remains unbounded. So in this way there is a hole, which is the deficiency of the electron. I'm writing all concepts in these points for better understanding of you. So third, a trivalent atom has a tendency to accept one electron from a neighboring silicon atom to complete the fourth covalent bond . This process requires a small amount of energy which is easily provided by the thermal agitation in the crystal. Fourth point is the transferred electron leaves behind a broken covalent bond that is a hole on silicon atom which acts as current carrier. And next to the point is the energy level levels for acceptor lies just above the top of the valence band. At a distance about 0.01 electron volt for germanium and about 0.046 to 0.016 electron volt for silicon. Meaning is that if this is conduction band and this is top of the valence band or valence band. So now the energy level for acceptors lies just above the valence band. So this is energy level 4 acceptor. Now next to the point is, I think it's 6th. An electron can be easily transferred to the acceptor levels by providing a small amount of energy. This energy or this creates a hole in the valence band which acts as a mobile current carrier. And next to the point that is very important to understand, that is the negative charge impurity atom, however, remains immobile and does not contribute to the conduction. Here, meaning is that this is the energy levels for acceptors. So by providing very small energy using temperature, electrons from the valence band can be captured by these impurity atoms. Let's say I am written at is B. So by capturing this fourth electron from the silicon, this boron will get a negative charge. Now this impurity atoms behave as negative charge, but these negative charge atoms don't take part in conduction because they have very high mass. So in this way we get some holes in valence band, and these holes can contribute to the conduction, or when we apply an electric field, these holes can move as per the direction of the electric field. So the electrons going from this valence band to these atoms are localized to these atoms only, and they don't take part in electrical conduction. So now let's calculate the whole concentration. In p-type semiconductor, again I am drawing conduction band and valence band. And we know for intrinsic semiconductor the Fermi level lies just between the valence band and the conduction band. Let's denote it by EI. And we know that the energy level for acceptor lies just above the valence band. Let's say it's EA. And for this P dot semiconductor, the Fermi level will be between EA and top of the valence band. Let's denote it as EF. That is Fermi level for P doped or P type semiconductor. So now let me write some points. First point is at T greater than 0, a part of acceptors is ionized by taking electrons from the valence band thus creating holes in the valence band which causes P-type apart from these holes, some thermally generated holes are also present. In वैलेंस बैंड। एंड सिमिलर नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन कंडक्शन बैंड। मीनिंग इज दैट देर आर सम होल्स ड्यू टू दीज इम्प्योरिटी एटम्स बट देर आर अदर टाइप्स ऑफ होल्स ऑल्सो देर ड्यू टू थर्मल एक्साइटेशन ऑफ सिलिकन एटम्स एंड ए सेम नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन कंडक्शन बैंड। सो हियर वी कैन राइट that is the total number of holes in valence band is let's say p which is equal to n and these electrons are thermally generated plus na minus the holes created by these impurity atoms. So this is the total number of holes. So now we have to calculate this Na plus Nn, and here since ionized atoms are larger than N, so we can write P almost equal to this ionized acceptor. So now our first purpose is to calculate this ionized number of ionized atoms. And this number can be calculated very easily. I think I didn't mention it in earlier case. So the number of ionized atoms can be calculated by knowing the exact number of impurity atoms that we are going to add, and if we multiply it by Fermi distribution function at energy A, then these Na and FeA will give us the number of ionized atoms, which is equal to, by putting the value of Fermi distribution function, that is 1 plus exponential Ea minus Ef by kT, and as we used in case of n-type semiconductor, that is assuming Ea minus Ef larger than kT, then we can omit this 1. So in this way we can write Na minus, which is equal to Na exponential Ef minus Ea by kT. But we know that as I calculated in the case of intrinsic semiconductor, P is equal to NP exponential minus EF minus EV by KT. So we have to use this equation first and equation second, that is P equal to NA minus, and this implies that NP exponential minus EF minus EV by KT into NA exponential EF minus EA . So by solving this equation we can get EF which is equal to EA plus EV by 2 minus KT by 2 log natural NA by NC. This is the Fermi energy, Fermi level 4 p-type semiconductor. And as I did in earlier case, by putting, let's say it's equation number 3rd, on putting the value of EF from 3 into 2, that is number of holes, we can get holes concentration in p-type semiconductor. And I am leaving this for you, that is put this value of EF into this equation, and from here you can get the number of holes or concentration of holes in p-type semiconductor. I am leaving it for you, please do it carefully. And from here we can see the Fermi level is almost in between the acceptor level and top of the valence band for p-type semiconductor. So let's write some point here for Fermi level in p-type semiconductor, that is Fermi level at moderate temperature lies near the middle of the acceptor level and top of the valence band. Second point B, it's very important, it moves towards or it moves upwards with increase in temperature and finally coincides with the intrinsic level. Please think about this. What is, why this is happening? And point C is the equation of EF, that is equation number 3. I think it's 3. Yeah, 3. Of EF is not valid at very high temperature where N, that is number of electrons, cannot be neglected. And as I did in earlier case, from here we can write the conductivity of p-type semiconductor by using same formula, Ep mu p, where mu p is the mobility of the p-type semiconductor. And we know that P equal to Na minus, so it is E Na minus mu P. So this is the conductivity of P-type semiconductor. And when we draw a graph between this conductivity and temperature, we can get a similar graph as I discussed for N-type semiconductor. So you can see that variation in last lecture. So now this is our last topic of our first unit, that is the equation of continuity or continuity equation. It's very important in solving some numerical problems. So in a semiconductor at a particular point, electrons or holes concentration could be affected by first could be affected by current, and current may be due to drifting of electrons or due to diffusion of carriers. That is, current due to drifting of charge carriers, and it may be due to diffusion of charge carriers. And second, when carriers are generated in silicon, at the same time recombination process is also occurred. So there is a competition between recombination and generation, and the number of electrons or carrier concentration depends upon this phenomenon. So the charge concentration can be vary by or can be affected by recombination. Or generation of charge carriers, and this generation of charge carriers may be thermally or by using thermal energy, and may be by light. So these are two regions that could affect the number of carriers at a particular point. So in continuity equation, we can calculate this number of charge carrier at a particular point. So for this, let me take a semiconductor and it's a p-type semiconductor, and in this semiconductor let me take a small volume of this semiconductor. And if this point is x, then this distance is delta x, and this point is x plus delta x, and A is its cross sectional area. So if there is a current in this direction, then there are some carriers due to generation of carriers that will increase the number of charge carriers in this volume, and at the same time due to this recombination, this recombination will decrease the number of charge carriers. So if there is current at this point is Jp x, where Jp is the current density of holes, and at this point this would be Jp x plus delta x. So by using all these factors we can determine the continuity equation. So first let me write at this point, that is the rate of change of number of holes with respect to time, and this would be G, and this volume is A into delta x. I can denote it by delta V. So due to generation there are some increment in the carriers, minus due to the recombination in this volume there is some decrease in the carriers. And plus number of or the current entering at this point x, which is equal to Jpx. This is density, current density, and if you multiply it by A we can get current, and if we divide this current by charge, then we can get number of charge here. So this term is also giving us the number of holes that are changing with respect to time. And this current is going away from this volume. So this will be Jp x plus delta x into A, and again we are going to divide it by Q. So for making it simpler, I can write it as G, sorry, it's not A, G delta V minus R delta V plus Jpx A, and I am multiplying it by delta x by Q. Then we have to divide it by delta x also, minus Jp x plus delta x at this point A delta x, and we have to divide it by Q. For making it simpler, so from here we can write it as del P or del T, where T is the time, and G del V minus R del V plus JPX, and we can write it as delta V by Q delta x minus Jp x plus del x del v, that is small volume of that element, Q delta x, and again we can write it as del v into G minus R plus Jp x plus Jpx by Q delta x minus Jp x plus del x by Q delta x. And here let me write it. What is P? P is the number of holes in this volume. So if I divide this P by V, delta V, that's delta V P by dt, which is equal to G minus R plus, here we can take 1 by Q, and can write it as Jp x minus Jp x plus del x by del x. So this change in the number of holes per unit time per this volume can be written as del rho for T. Here rho equal to P or delta V, that is, this is the holes density. So this is the change in the holes density, which is equal to G minus R plus 1 by Q. And we can see this is the definition of a differentiation, and in differentiation this term will come first and this will come after that. So we can write this as minus del Jp and del x. So ultimately we get del rho over del t, which is equal to g minus r minus 1 by q del jp. So this is the continuity equation for a semiconductor. And we can assume if generation is equal to r, then we can delete this g and r. And here this current density is the combination of current by drifting of carriers and by diffusion of current carriers. So this equation can be used to determine the carrier concentration at any point at any instant . So this is the continuity equation . In next lecture we will start unit 2 of our syllabus.